Hey there, in this video, I'll show you how to install WordPress in Hostinger, set up a proper Hostinger WordPress website, how to add a custom modern looking theme like this one, how to optimize your images, and we'll be creating a professional business email address. In this Hostinger WordPress tutorial video, I'm covering it all, so let's not waste any more time and start. Now, the first logical step is to have a Hostinger account. If you have it already, skip to the next part of this tutorial. If you're about to buy one, well, web hosting plans here start at around $1.50 a month currently. And Hostinger sells both hosting and domain names, so we can get everything in one place. Hostinger offers some of the best cheap web hosting plans in the industry, and has the performance to back it up. In this video, I'll kill two birds with one stone and choose the plan with both great hosting and a free domain name. That's what we're gonna do. By the way, if you're considering Hostinger, I add the best WordPress web hosting deals in the description. So check those out once you know how it handles. The buying process is simple. Pick a plan, select the hosting period you want to prepay, and fill in all your information. After that, just pay, and in a few minutes, you should receive an email with further login information. Don't be scared if you didn't select a domain name yet. You'll do all of that while setting up for the first time. Okay, so the first time you log in to your account, this Hostinger WordPress setup will appear. Click Start Now and choose if you're creating a brand new website or want to migrate an existing site to Hostinger. We'll choose the new site option. Just select WordPress and create login details for your administrator account. Next, we'll be skipping the template selection. These are quite nice and modern templates, but we'll be going with a different approach, so just skip this step for now. After that, you'll need to choose if you want to use a new domain name or an existing one. This is where domain name registration comes in. Just type in your wanted name and extension, and Hostinger will check the domain database whether this combo is available. If it's already taken, you'll be suggested a different combo. Once you find the name you want, register your information and confirm your site's name. And just wait for Hostinger to set everything up automatically. If you type in your website name into the browser, you would see the default WordPress theme and some demo content like this. The problem is that it doesn't look very impressive and, well, doesn't give confidence to your user. Luckily, it's super easy to manage. Go to your admin panel, click the Appearance tab on the left side, and click Add New on the top of the page. Now, we're going to add a different theme. Just type in Astra. Choose this theme, click Install, and then finally activate. After that, you should see a banner appear at the top of the page. Click here, and it should automatically install and activate the plugin that you need. If this banner doesn't appear, just install and activate a plugin called Starter Templates. Once it's done, and you see this page, select Elementor. First, we can't remove premium options, so if a template has this premium tag at the top, it's going to be paid. Find and choose a free theme that best fits your needs. Open up that template, and click Select Logo. Now, just upload your logo file from your PC, adjust the width with this slide, and click Continue. If you're looking for more customization, it's cool that the color scheme and fonts can easily be changed. Just head to the next page. It's kind of self-explanatory, so experiment until you find the combo you like. Once all of that is done, fill in this form and click Submit and Build My Website. Finally, after the robots are done crafting the new design, if you click here, you can see your brand new website. It has images, text, and pages already created. If you click this button, you can edit every page with Elementor. It's really easy. Just select an element and change its settings and content in the left panel. What's nice is that Hostinger offers useful drag and drop elements. And you can also pull up a secondary menu when just clicking the right mouse button. If you want more Elementor tutorials, I'll make one about building a site with Elementor very soon. So, subscribe to this channel to stay up to date, and if this video was helpful, give it a like! Hostinger installations come with a free LiteSpeed Cache plugin already installed. Caching is like a temporary storage space where your website files get put. This means that the files don't need to be loaded if the user visited your content, meaning faster loading for returning visitors. LiteSpeed Cache is activated by default, so you don't need to do anything extra. A faster site equals happier users, so that's a nice free plus from Hostinger. If you're planning on having lots of high-quality photos on your site, like in a blog or a portfolio, optimizing your images is a must. Big images can clog up your website's loading time, and you don't even need that high resolution or file size for web projects. First, let's add lots of images and demonstrate how it affects loading times. Now, all of these are not optimized, and right now my website takes around 2.9 megabytes of space and loads in around 2.2 seconds on average. Let's go to your WordPress dashboard, hover over plugins, and click Add New. In the search bar, type in Tiny PNG, and click Install Now, then Activate. Just register an account. And once registered, in your WordPress dashboard, hover on Media. Then select Bulk Optimizations and click this big button. It will take some time, but this plugin will reduce the size of all your pictures without losing noticeable quality. If I were to do another test right now, I would reduce my website size by around 40% and increase the speed up to 1.4 seconds. Pretty good upgrade considering it took less than 5 minutes. And if we take a look at the optimized images, they're as good as our original ones. Adding your personal email to your website is a serious no-go, and I found adding a professional one fairly simple. You'll just want to head to your Hostinger control panel, and next to your hosting plan, click Manage. Scroll down to where it says Email Accounts. Next, just type in the email address you want to use and the password that you'll use to access this email box. Then click Create. I recommend linking your personal Gmail address with this inbox. In your dashboard, go to the email settings. You'll see a lot of information like IMAP servers, POP3, and SMTP servers. Keep this window open. Log into your Gmail account, click on this icon, and then click Settings. Next, go into Accounts and Import, and then click Add Mail Account. Type in the mail account that you've created with Hostinger. Then choose the POP3 option. Next, type in your email address and password again. For the POP server, use pop.hostinger.com and choose the 995 port. You can tick the first three boxes as well. Now, choose Yes, I want to be able to send mail as your email address, and click Next. Type in the name you want other people to see when you're sending emails from your new professional email account. I'll just name mine Cyber News Hosting and click Next Step. Now type in smtp.hostinger.com as your SMTP server. Then enter your email address and password once again. Choose the 587 port and connect using TLS. Click Add Account. It's a lot of clicking and numbers, so don't be frustrated if something goes wrong. Try again. You only need to do this kind of thing once. If everything was done correctly, you will get an email where you'll need to click a confirmation link. Once you click it, click confirm, and that's it. Your personal and business email accounts are linked in a beautiful friendship. I really think Hostinger is the best web hosting provider and has an easy-to-use control panel as well as fast WordPress-optimized servers. If you give Hostinger a try, I know you'll love it. And that's pretty much it. We looked at how to start using the best web hosting for WordPress, Hostinger, learned how to install new WordPress, add a customizable theme to it, and finally create a professional email account. So, everything that a modern business website would need for a fresh start. If you have any more questions about Hostinger, leave them in the comments below and I'll try to answer all of them. Did this video help you out? If so, maybe leave a like on it so I know I'm doing a good job. In all seriousness, it means a lot that all this work is actually useful. So I'll go do some more research, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!